Hello. Of the Ga pronoun lesson, and today we shall be looking at the Ga future pronouns, and this is definitely the fourth part in the series because we had earlier looked at the Ga introduction to Ga pronouns, Ga subject pronouns, the past and present situations, Ga continuous and object pronouns, then the Ga future pronouns. Well, I would like to urge everyone to keep sharing this lesson because many people wish to learn Ga and Dangbon. And as we are doing this, we encourage you to share with others, anyone you know wishing or always desiring to learn Ga but do not know where to start from. This is a free platform. You don't have to pay any fees. All you have to do is just put on data, and at your own pace, you are able to learn. Also, if you wish for private Ga classes, you can just contact me and I'll be glad to assist. So without much time we waste, let's just begin. So Ga future pronouns. Like we have earlier said, Ga pronouns are inflected as compared to the Ga verbs. So then, as we had grasped that concept, we are just going to list out the Ga future pronouns. So we have ma, ma, obaa, obaa, ebaa, ebaa, wobaa, wobaa, nyebaa, nyebaa, amebaa, amebaa, and the last one, abaa, abaa. So technically the Ga future pronouns are more of subjects, okay, they are subject inflected. So let's start with ma, let's form sentences. So ma simply means I will or I would or I shall. Okay, it means I will, I would, or I shall. Like I earlier told you, it's just a future pronoun. That means either way it is translated to English, which would make sense, then that is it. It's not really specific. We don't really have specific words for I will, I would, and I shall. No. All we have is ma. So let's say ma ba, I will come, or I would come, or I shall come. Maba. So ba is the verb. So if you had earlier realized or you had followed the early lessons, imba, I came. Imba, I should come. Okay. Then meba, I am coming. So that the Ga continuous pronoun. But then maba, I will come. So if you are now seeing this lesson and you've not visited the previous lessons, kindly check the description box below and it will take you to the beginning, that's introduction to Ga pronouns. The introduction to Ga pronouns will take you to the next lesson, which is the Ga subject pronouns, and then it continues that way. Also check the description box below to find the Ga cultural videos, that's vocabularies in Ga religion, okay, both the Mla cult, the Mla Etikali cult, and then the lecture of the Ga region. So there are three lessons in the description box below. That is the introduction to Ga pronouns and then the Ga traditional religion, because they are very, very important. People always like to know about religion. So let's continue. Ye means to eat. So maye, I will eat. I will eat. Maye ni, I will eat food, or I will eat, technically. Maye ni. Manunu, manunu, I will drink water. Manunu. Oga means Accra, so I'll go to Accra. Mayaga, I'll go to Accra. Masha Nibiam. Masha Nibiami. Masha Nibiami. So I would wash utensils. Utensils are Nibi. Nibi translated as things. But then, all the translated as things, we see it as utensils because we wash utensils. We don't wash things. So I'll wash things. Masha Nibiam. Like I've earlier told you, MLI is pronounced as me and not me. Well, in written Ghan, we write me. But in spoken Ghan, we say me. Then the last example, Mafangbe. Mafangbe, I will travel. So the verbs are not really necessary for this, but the pronouns you are looking at. Well, you can still keep the sentence in your mind, but the essentials of this lesson is just to study the pronoun pattern. So, our next word, obaa. Obaa. Obaa ba alo. Obaa, will you ba come? Obaa ba alo, will you come? So, alo means or. Alo means or, but then in Ghan, you say you will come or, it's not only in Ghan, in Ghanaian languages, all Ghanaian languages, you want to ask a question, use or. So you will come or, obaa ba alo. Emaba, yes, I will come. Obaa ba alo, emaba. Obaa ye ni, will you eat? Obaa ye ni, or obaa ye ni alo, will you eat? Or obaa ye ni alo, will you eat? The alo is just like a question mark. Why any alo? Will you eat? Am I any? Yes, I will eat. Okay. Obaya school. Obaya school. You will go to school. Obaya school. Obaya Solomon. Obaya Solomon. Obaya Solomon. You will go to church. Obaya Nikasimo. Obaya Nikasimo. Nikasimo means learning center. So the Jehovah Witnesses call their kingdom hall Nikasimo. That's their service called Nikasimo. And Nikasimo also means a learning center. So Obaya Nikasimo is if you're a witness, it means you are going to the kingdom hall or you are going to a learning center. Okay, so the next one, ebaa, ebaa, ebaa ya choko, ebaa ya choko. He will go to choko or she will go to choko. In Oga, we don't gender pronouns, so e means he or she. Ebaa ya choko, he will go to choko or she will go to choko. Choko is a place at Accra. Ebaa nma me. Ebaa nma ni, he will write or she will write. Ebaa ye ni. Ebaa ye ni. Ebaa ye ni. Ebaa ye ni. Ebaa ye ni means he will eat or she will eat. Ebaa ye ni. So now with ebaa, let's start to the A with a name. Kwashi baa ye ni. So we make you bring a name, okay? The A must vanish. So Kwashi baa ni, Kwashi will eat. Tete baa ningo. Tete baa ningo. Tete will go to ningo. Odai baba shia. Odai baba shia. Odai will come home. Odai will come home. Then, na bafangbe. Na bafangbe. Na will travel. Na will travel. Hope we are getting it. So now let's go to wobaa. Wobaa. So, wobaa kashin, we will sit down. Wobaa kashin, we will sit down. Wabayeni, we will eat. Wabayeni, we will eat. Wabanye, we can. So in Ga we will say we will can, or we will be able to. Nye is from the verb nyemo, that's to be able to. So we will be able to. Wabanye, we will be able to, or we can. Wabanye. Wabanye waya, we can go, or we'll be able to go. Wabanye waya, we can go. Wabanye wahoni, we can cook. Wabanye wahoni, we can cook. Then nyebaa. Nyebaa tashi, you, that's a plural version. Nyebaa tashi, you will sit down. So nye is the plural you, not the singular. So nyebaa tashi, you will sit down. Nyebaa fagbe, you will travel. Nyebata koyolelemi, you will sit in plane. So koyolele is airplane. Nyebata koyolelemi, you will sit in airplane. Nyebata motono. Nyebata motono, you will sit on moto. Then we have amebaa, they will go. Amebaa, they will go. Amebaa, they will go. So now let's use names over here. Make a coffee, baba. Make a coffee. Now, let me explain this much better. You can say make a coffee, baba, but then it's fucking gone. We barely use it. What we say is inke a coffee, baba. Inke a coffee, baba. Coffee and I would come. Kofi and I will certainly walk baba, but then they'll walk. If we place with his names, Inka Kofi Baba. Kwashi ke anang baya. Kwashi ke anang baya. That's Kwashi is a name and anang will go. Kwashi ke anang baya. Then we have Odai ke afute. Bayeni, Odake Afute Bayeni. Then we have Botele ke Botioko. Bahoni. Botele ke Botioko. Bahoni. Kwete ke Kwenoki. Baya Suku. Kwete ke Kwenoki. Baya Suku. So we've still not forgotten the abaa is still in mind. Abaa. Abaa fagbe, one will travel or they will travel. Now I thought that abaa is an anonymous pronoun. So they will travel or one will travel. Abaa fagbe. Abaa bani, abaa bani. They will plead for a gift or they will plead for food. Ni usually standing for food, but it can also mean anything. So they'll beg for anything, so they'll beg for food. Ababa ni. Abaa shasini, they would videotape a video, something like that. Because sini is video, so they'll take a video. They'll take a video. Yeah, abaa shasini. Abaa shasini. Okay. Abaa jani, one will share something, or they will share something. So we would end here for today. This is a short lesson. Thank you very, very much for joining us once again for another lesson. And at this moment, I would like to still introduce the book, No Ghana Better. No Ghana Better is a book which was written by me, where I documented all the issues in Ghana. And there are 9 ethnic groups, Ga-Dangme, Akan, Guan, Senufo, the Guru, and the Guru, we have the Dagbon, Gurma, Gurunsi. Then we have the annexes, that's the Ghana-Togo Mountain Languages. Ghana-Togo Mountain Languages are also seen as Guans, but they are an entire ethnic group on their own, as well as the Ewe group of languages, making 9. And in a book, I documented the histories of all the 9 ethnic groups. Well, when you take Ga-Dangme, we have Ga and Dangme. So the issues of the Ga's have been covered, Dangme's have been covered. And Ga, we have the Nuba community, Teshin, Tema, Pong, La, Osu, Ga. All the issues have been covered. When you get to Dangme, we have Bugbuna, Nugo, Shai, Osudoku, and Ko. Accounts, we have Tapa, Rara, Asante, Achim, technically everyone. The ones, all the Guan communities, no one was left. The detailed histories, the festival they celebrate, the food they eat, the locality, the languages they speak, the dialect, everything has been covered. The migration account, the contrasting views, and thought-provoking stories were all covered in the book. The book is over 400 pages. Well, the soft copy of the book can be purchased from the African Read site, which you can find a description the book in the description box below. And it is going for a very cheap rate. Well, if you desire the hard copy of the book, it will come out in April, and I will soon announce where you can get it. But at the moment, the samples of the hard copy can be found at the Padmore Library at Accra. And if in case you want a glance, yes, you can go there. Also, as we all know, Ghanaian histories were not fully documented. So documenting them now, as most African historians are trying to do, there are always debates and controversies. So as an individual author who is mindful of this, and as well, I'm also against tribal bigotry, because I'm not only teaching Ga and Dangme, I teach Guan language as well. I speak Hausa, I speak European languages, I speak even Dagbon. So there's no way I'm going to take sides. I stand in for most Ghanaian languages. So because of that, I barely take sides when it comes to ethnic groups or languages. So because I wish to avoid bigotry at all costs, I have annexed a blog for the book, which is called No Ghana Better Blog. And you can find the link historicalhuniah.blogspot.com in the description box below. So in as much as you buy the book, there are articles on the blog which kind of supplement what is in the book. Well, the written copies are already being printed, and when there are updates, it will be difficult to make changes unless the next edition. But with the soft copies or the African Read, the edits are easy to make. So for that, for the soft copies, there's not much of a problem. But for the sake of the hard copies, the blog was created so that as and when there are controversies and stuff, with more updates, and I'm still learning more and more, so I keep publishing them on the blog. So the blog serves as an annex to the book. Well, I'm not stating that the book do not have accurate issues, no, they have, but even at the moment, you all bear witness that there was a new documentary video which has been uploaded and has been documented in the blog. So in the next edition, the book will be updated with all those histories. So in as much as you may go in for the hard copy of the book, just know that the blog is also serving as a place where more and more history and findings are being documented. So kindly patronize the blog as well, and I'll urge you all to get the book. The hard copies should be out in April, and I'll announce where to get them. Also, you can follow the Telegram channel Ghanaian Language Advocacy by my brother Emmanuel Anu, and it's an annex of the Learn Ghanaian Languages Huniah franchise, where he tries his best to advertise whatever lesson, be it on the Guan channel, the Ga-Dangme channel, or the Polyglot channel. My Polyglot channel is for the study of European languages and culture, and documentaries. So Sananex also, it has other functions, it also plays. So if so, kindly subscribe to that channel on Telegram, Ghanaian Language Advocacy, so as to be abreast with whatever lessons are being uploaded on this channel. Also, if you wish to learn Guan languages, don't hesitate, just search Huniah on YouTube and you easily locate the Guan channel. Thank you very, very much for how far we've come and how far you've brought us. Thank you, and I'd like to say nyebaa, and express the next lesson on Ga emphatical pronouns. Dagbon lessons have still not been forgotten. They would be uploaded again. And if you're a Dagbon learner, just be expecting the next Dagbon lessons. On Dagbon, this is 4. Thank you. Nyebaa. Go, go.